from Matthew Henry's commentary on Matthew 24:12. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. The general declining and cooling of most. In seducing times, when false prophets arise, in persecuting times, when the saints are hated, expect these two things. 1. The abounding of iniquity. Though the world always lies in wickedness, yet there are some times in which it may be said that iniquity doth in a special manner abound, as when it is more extensive than ordinary, as in the old world, when all flesh had corrupted their way, and when it is more excessive than ordinary, when violence is risen up to a rod of wickedness, Ezekiel 7:11. So that hell seems to be broke loose in blasphemies against God, and enmities to the saints. 2. The abating of love. This is the consequence of the former. Because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. Understand it in general of true serious godliness, which is all summed up in love. It is too common for professors of religion to grow cool in their profession, when the wicked are hot in their wickedness, as the Church of Ephesus in bad times left her first love, Revelation 2:2-4. Or it may be understood more particularly of brotherly love. When iniquity abounds, seducing iniquity, persecuting iniquity, this grace commonly waxes cold. Christians begin to be shy and suspicious one of another. Affections are alienated, distances created, parties made, and so love comes to nothing. The devil is the accuser of the brethren, not only to their enemies, which makes persecuting iniquity abound, but one to another, which makes the love of many to wax cold. This gives a melancholy prospect of the times, that there shall be such a great decay of love, but, first, it is of the love of many, not of all. In the worst of times, God has his remnant that hold fast their integrity and retain their zeal, as in Elijah's days, when he thought himself left alone. Secondly, this love is grown cold, but not dead. It abates, but is not quite cast off. There is life in the root, which will show itself when the winter is past. The new nature may wax cold, but shall not wax old, for then it would decay and vanish away. 3. Comfort administered in reference to this offense of the cross, for the support of the Lord's people under it. Verse 13. He that endures to the end shall be saved. It is comfortable to those who wish well to the cause of Christ in general, that, though many are offended, yet some shall endure to the end. When we see so many drawing back, we are ready to fear that the cause of Christ will sink for want of supporters, and his name be left and forgotten for want of some to make profession of it. But even at this time there is a remnant according to the election of grace, Romans 11:5. It is spoken of the same time that this prophecy has reference to a remnant who are not of them that draw back unto perdition, but believe and persevere to the saving of the soul. They endure to the end of their lives, to the end of their present state of probation, or to the end of the suffering, trying times, to the last encounter, though they should be called to resist unto blood. It is comfortable to those who do thus endure to the end and suffer for their constancy that they shall be saved. Perseverance wins the crown through free grace and shall wear it. They shall be saved. Perhaps they may be delivered out of their troubles, and comfortably survive them in this world. But it is eternal salvation that is here intended. They that endure to the end of their days shall then receive the end of their faith and hope, even the salvation of their souls. 1 Peter 1:9, Romans 2:7, Revelation 3:20. The crown of glory will make amends for all, and a believing regard to that will enable us to choose rather to die at a stake with the persecuted than to live in a palace with the persecutors.